The following program is rated mature. It may contain strong, coarse language, violence, and other mature content not appropriate for children under 17. The views expressed in this program may not represent those of this cable station or its employees.
It's 9 o'clock on a Friday night, so grab a seat and you just might see something really great. You've got the time, it's not too late to watch a show that will give you laughs and chills and thrills. There's nothing that they haven't tried, 'cause everything tastes great when it's deep fried. So lock your doors and sit right down, there is no better place to go, 'cause it's time for the Not So Late Show.
Sorry, we're just trying to figure out how to break things between the two of us, three of us, four of us? Between all of us.
Four of us, soon to be three.
Soon to be three. Because, Pat's not here.
Run!
Oh. We've always been a little off, but all right, sure.
Unfortunately, Pat was killed in a tragic go-kart accident where he walked out onto the go-kart track and, just got waffled by it.
Okay. I was expecting something more, honestly.
No.
No?
That's it.
No? He wasn't killed by the adorable kitten that he has?
We don't know if he has it or if he's watching it or whatnot.
All I know is that that kitten is absolutely, like, one of the most adorable cats I've ever seen. Cool. I mean, it is internet-level cute.
Huh.
I mean, it's...
Bye, Dr. Nick.
Right? Here, Doug. Just real... Oh, wait, I'm sorry. Well...
Yeah, go for it.
Nah, don't worry about it, because there's no one in the control room to select it.
We have Doug.
Doug.
And Rob was out of here like his ass is on fire because he's on vacation.
Here's the kitten. See, you can see it. It's internet level cute. I know you can totally tell at home from that. It's 30 feet away on SD image. It's like 3 pixels by 3 pixels. But trust me, it's adorable.
I can vouch for that.
Yeah, it's adorable. So, Jay, how was your week?
Semi-eventful.
Really? How was it eventful?
Because I did something that you cannot claim yet.
Poop 8 times in one day?
No, you can claim that. I've been on vacation with you.
Okay, fair enough. Yeah. All right, yeah.
No, I can finally say that I own the slightest of slightest of slightest hair width of Hawaii, and you don't.
What?
Uh-huh.
You own a piece of Hawaii?
Very, very, very.
Wait,
very,
you bought property out there?
No, I bought stock in a company that's out there.
You bought stock in a company that's out there?
Yes, because remember what I tried to do last time we were on the show?
For those of you who tuned in last week, Jay tried to buy stock in a wine company called Kona Red and failed to do so because no money was deposited in his account. But
now it is.
All right,
and I bought shares.
All right, how many shares did you buy exactly?
2,000.
Holy crap!
But it was only 6 cents each.
So that works out to $120.
Yeah, about.
Okay, so what's the ticker symbol for this now?
K-Red.
It's
you found it for me. You should know.
I wasn't paying attention, like most stockbrokers. You know.
Or show viewers.
Wait, why are you back?
Forgot to do eat time.
You know what I just noticed?
Jay, it's down 2.5% today.
Oh, so
to 0.06 cents.
Yay, I'm still break even.
It's
that freaking thing hasn't budged.
No.
No, what I did notice is that none of the tally lights are working on any of the cameras. So now it's just like, guess where they are.
Well, that's usually how it is.
Okay, good luck on that, then.
Yeah.
Okay.
I was like, vacation, see ya.
See ya.
Ooh, 157 days ago, Kona Red Corporation reports positive growth trend in cold brew. Cold brew what? Oh, sales.
Oh.
Coffee sales.
So they went from 2 cents to 6 cents. That would be a positive uptrend.
Maybe.
Mm.
Yep.
Actually, I can look it up live.
So what happened? What did they do anything 6 months ago? What's the whole 1 year of this? Oh well, 1 year ago. Oh wow, they were as low as 5 cents.
Hey, where they are right now?
They were up to 7 cents like a month ago, and now they're kind of flat line there. Yeah, so there you go. From Microcap Daily on the move, Kona Red Corp.
They're physically moving locations. Their office used to be here.
Well,
now it moved across the parking lot.
Well, it's on the rise in recent weeks since reversing off 0.044 lows. So you didn't get it at the bottom.
Yeah. Oh, darn, I got it at 6 cents instead of 4.
No. Yeah. Yep.
I'll never see that $2 again.
Yep. Anyways, so Jay, what else did you do this week besides buy stock?
I read a book.
You read, what did you read?
I'm a little behind the times, I'm not going to lie, but I finally read the first Harry Potter book.
Okay. And what did you think of it?
It was very Harry Pottery.
All right, and did it adhere to the movie adhere to it, or what?
Never seen the movies.
What?
I own every movie.
I know, this is why I'm a little
Thanks,
confused
Amazon.
Why I haven't seen any of them.
Thanks, Amazon. And I've actually owned them for like a year or two. And so I finally, our friend Evan, he is a huge Harry Potter fan. He owns every book, so he let me borrow every book.
Okay.
A month or two ago. So I finally got around to reading number 1 of 7.
Well, hooray. Sure.
I did an adulting thing, too.
I'm afraid to ask, but all right.
I fixed my sink.
Really?
Yeah.
What was wrong with your sink?
Well, you've been to my house many times, and you know that when you...
I have. Your house was made in, like, seven... It was, like, I think that was George Washington's original house.
It was George Washington's original house, not widely known.
If he stayed in Torrington.
If he did ever come to Torrington once in his existence. No, but my kitchen sink, because I have well water.
And the kitchen sink?
And the kitchen sink.
And the kitchen sink.
Rust likes to eat away at all my rubbery parts.
Okay.
And so finally I was at the point where I shut the
water
off.
Well, someday you'll be a real boy and you won't have to worry about those robot problems.
That's very true. So I was shutting the faucet off and the water just kept coming out.
And that's the problem.
So I said, help me, YouTube. And they did.
Uh-huh.
They said, oh, it's a Delta faucet. This is very easy. Watch this. And like a minute later, the guy had the whole thing apart. Now go to your hardware store, and they'll have all the replacement parts. So I went to a local...
I'm sorry, all I can picture is, like 5 minutes later, after watching the internet videos, like water shooting to the ceiling, and you're like...
That was on fire.
Damn it! Yeah, the water was somehow on fire.
On fire.
Yeah.
So
there's a fountain of flames.
So I went to a local big box hardware store that might have the color orange associated with it.
So Lowe's.
Yes.
Yep.
And they had it was a kit for... Delta repair kit.
Yep.
For Delta faucets. I'm like, oh, wow, that just has everything. Bought that, brought it home, and just reverse ordered what I took apart and shoved it all back together. Bye again. And to my amazement, it worked.
Wow. That's pretty fancy.
And then I turned the water on.
And?
It still worked.
Oh, even better.
I know.
It's
it
amazing.
Was weird.
Oh, my God.
A double rainbow.
And then.
Oh, no.
Hey, Doug, would you be so kind as to deliver in a GoPro?
Yes, you got a new toy.
I got a new toy this week.
You devil, you.
Yeah. So I broke down and decided to get the new GoPro Hero 5 Black. Hey,
it's Why does it got to be about color with you?
Because it's black.
Because black is better, actually.
Yeah. Thank you. No, it's fine.
And
oh,
I agree with that.
It's broken now.
And I agree with that on many levels.
No. So, first of all... You okay over there?
Yeah, no, that was good.
Sure.
No, yeah, it's broken now.
Yep. I got a new GoPro. It's broken. No, I'm kidding.
Damn it, Doug. You son
so
of a
here's
bitch.
The major differences with it. So form factor wise, this looks fairly similar. You know, if I were to show you this, like, okay, hey, what's this? Oh, God, someone would be like, it's a
well,
GoPro.
Wait, you always make me do this. So I'm going to make you do it. Tell people what GoPro is, what their claim to fame is.
Sure. So GoPro is the world's most prolific and well-known action camera company. They produce action cameras basically in really small form factors. They've been making them for, since the mid-2000s, early 2000s, I want to say.
Is that long now?
Well, keep in mind, they weren't on this refresh cycle that they are now. You know, for several years, it was like the Hero original, and before that, they actually had analog film cameras.
Really?
For real.
No shit.
Yeah.
Oh.
It was like analog film cameras that were designed to like fit on your surfboard. But now, that's a little bit... There
Hard
we go.
Oh.
All right.
By the way, just to go back to mine for 5 seconds,
uh-huh.
since I first invested after the last show, so Monday, when uh-huh. the markets were open, I'm up $10.35.
Are you really?
I am.
That's fancy.
So I can now retire.
From stock trading?
Yeah, basically. There's nothing else I can retire.
That's pretty much it.
Anyway, continue.
So this... is the new GoPro Hero 5 black, because there is a session which is considerably smaller. Now,
I don't suppose there's one of Rob sitting around so you can compare it to a two or three, huh? No.
So basically, the really small form factor and the really tough. I'm not going to drop it because this one's mine.
if it was Rob, screw it.
It's not a loner or anything like that. No, this one's mine. So they make really small form factor and they record really high quality video. I can say that I have personally recorded video on GoPro cameras for broadcast on major network. So that's like the type of quality you get out of these things.
This one's 4K?
This can do 4K video, yeah.
And how many frames?
30. Eh. But, all right, so if you had the Hero 4 Black, it has very similar recording snaps to that, but it lacked a touchscreen.
Which is already fingerprinted to hell.
Yes, it is. I've already put my own hackneyed screen protector on here. But I am just going to fire this up here. And this does have actually some new features over the old one, which is really handy.
Such as?
Well, for instance, all right.
The first question is, because I'm familiar with GoPro, because you've made me familiar. Thank you. Does that fit into original cases and such?
No, it's got a new case. But here's the difference.
No.
Hero 4 required a waterproof case, right?
Right.
This is waterproof.
It's waterproof itself.
On its own to 33 feet.
Not 34 feet.
33. But that's going to cover, 90% of your applications. Of course, if you're going deeper than that, this is fine for swimming, surfing, rain, weather, all that.
So if you're going to go splash around the pool with the kids, it's fine.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Unless your swimming pool
goes down
to 33
feet. But if you're going diving, you need a specific case. But that's great because that was one of the pains in the ass. Is you have to put the freaking thing in the case, and then you had to worry about the case fogging up. That was always a big problem. So now
not anymore, suckers.
So now it comes with a skeleton case, basically. So this is
that was dirty.
It was so you can attach it to the standard GoPro complement of mounts. This is actually, I can't remember the name of the company that makes this, but this is a really cool mount. You can also use as a handle. But it's cool. You can zip tie it down to stuff. It's really cool.
Here is my handle.
Anyways, one of the differences is you have similar frame rates. You have a bunch more shooting modes in terms of frame rates. It has image stabilization now not for 4K, but anything pretty much less than 4K and less than 60 frames or less. It will have image stabilization. It has a new linear mode that eliminates fisheye, which is really cool.
So you can do it like a normal camera raw.
So yeah, you have kind of like a flat plane of viewing plane rather than like that traditional GoPro really wide. But this is one of my favorite features. So sometimes you just have this like mounted on a helmet or you have it mounted on your jacket, and I'm sitting here and maybe I've got ski poles or I'm swimming or something like that, or it's mounted on the top of a surfboard, and I can go, GoPro, start recording.
No way.
Yes. So now it's recording a video of Jay in 1080p 60 right now is what I have it set. GoPro, take a burst. GoPro, take a burst. Oh, probably can't do it while I'm recording. GoPro, stop recording. GoPro, shoot a burst.
Oh.
So there you go. Shot a burst while doing that. GoPro, start recording. GoPro, shoot a burst. Now, all right. So you can't shoot. You can't shoot a burst while it's already recording.
I'm
GoPro,
already
stop
not
recording.
Liking it.
GoPro, go to photo mode. GoPro, take a photo. GoPro, go to video mode. GoPro, start recording. GoPro, that was sick. And it just tagged it right there for later reference.
Really?
Yes. It was a little tag in the corner. You probably can't see it on the camera here. There's a little yellow dot there.
That's funny.
So, GoPro, stop recording. That is actually, when I first heard about this feature, in my head, I mocked it a little bit.
Now you're in love with it.
This is a lot handier. Just knowing how I've used these in the past, this is a lot handier than...
Hold on. Let me hit the button until I get to the right mode. Now I gotta...
Yeah.
Hold on.
Well, that's great. Well, one of the great things is it has a really intuitive touchscreen menu on the back. So I can go here, and here's like 1080, and I can be like, nope, I want to shoot in 2.7K, and I want to shoot at 60 frames a second, and I want a medium field of view. So there you go. Or maybe I want a linear field of view. Like so, which is kind of gets rid of that fisheye. And it's real easy to get through the menus. I can browse through. So here I can, sorry, I put a really crappy screen protector on the back here. So it's a little, less sensitive than that would normally be, yeah. But I just want to protect it. So here's some photos I shot of Jay. Yep, here's one here. There's one of you. I can even slide through. Can I zoom in? Now here's the video I shot of you.
GoPro, that was sick.
And there, tagged it there. And actually, the speaker on this.
There's a little tag in the corner. You probably can't see it on the camera here.
That's something you're not used to.
Yeah, not at all.
Because it doesn't have a speaker on previous versions.
Look how damn tiny the thing is for everything that it can do. So,
which is really cool. Also, for the first time, it has built-in GPS.
Really?
Yes. So this will record your, the location of, you know, where you're shooting or where your photos are. It will geotag them, which is really cool. So that, like, when you import those into iPhoto or any of your other photo editing programs like Lightroom or something like that, it, you know, alongside your iPhone ones, it'll tag them with location just the same. So, of course, this also has really good Wi-Fi controls as well. I'm actually going to connect up really quickly to Wi-Fi on this. I think, did I turn it off?
Wi-Fi.
I turned it off like a fool. Oh, and I just told it to turn off. GoPro, turn on. Damn it.
No, I'm totally not sold.
Well, when you're an idiot like me and you tell the GoPro to discontinue usage. Mm. God damn it. It shot a burst.
Discontinue usage, shoot a burst. I can see how close those are.
Yes. Anyways, I'm just going to turn on. So... there's voice control. Oh, I have to go back to connect. Wireless connection's on. There we go. Now I can connect up via Wi-Fi, which is really cool. Of course, you could do this with previous Hero 4 Silver and Hero 4 Black. But this is cool and probably just more cool than actually useful. Is in addition to having... preview on your phone, like I can right here, so you can actually see a little bit better. There's Jay. Here's me, and you can see it's actually fairly close.
In real time. Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty close to real time. Now the real fun gets to be if you have an Apple Watch, because I can go ahead and I can pull this up here, and I'll just go to the GoPro app on my watch. I can.
You've already started recording.
Have I?
You have.
Oh, well, crap. Didn't mean to do that.
No, you're not recording.
Nope.
Connect?
Well, normally...
well, can you connect two devices at the same time?
Ah, here we go. I can control...
and you broke it.
Of course, I have to log into my Florgan watch.
Now everyone knows your code. Now everyone can use your watch.
Yeah, I'm sure they'll follow that on SDTV. So if you can see this big red button, I can start recording from my watch, which is great. It's kind of a remote controller because you're not necessarily going to have your phone out if you're in a precarious position, but you can with your phone. It's very easy. And the real fun part is I can also preview. This is really tough to see, but on my watch right now is a preview of GoPro.
Because if you can't see the image on the large screen phone, we're sure you're going to be able to see it on a little watch.
No, but this is handy.
Oh, it's very cool. Don't get me wrong.
I mean, it's cool, but it's handy if only for the fact that I'm not going to have my phone out all, you know, at all times, but I will always be wearing my watch.
Will you, though? I remember your Pebble.
I know, but then, yeah, no, but this is way more useful. Anyways, so that's cool. So overall, it's not perfect. I would have loved to have seen... the battery life is to be determined because I've actually had to wear it down, but so far, so good. Not terrible. I would have liked to have... sorry, Doug, I know I'm leaning out of your way here.
He's a leaner.
I would have liked to have seen 60p or 60 frames per second on 4K. That would have been the be-all and end-all. The audio quality is pretty good. Not blowing me away. I do like the fact that it
can
has...
can you hook external audio to that?
You can...
I feel a butt coming.
So there's, it requires an adapter.
Like a proprietary adapter?
It's a GoPro adapter.
So yes.
Sort of, yeah. But here's why. So you have a couple connectors on here, and I'm going to fold this out, which won't be able to see for the moment, but you can see here there's actually a rubber gasket seal around the store. Well, you probably can't see it at home, but trust me, that little gray part right there, that's a rubber gasket seal. Now, as far as connectors on this, it has two connectors on the side. One is a mini HDMI. There you go. And the other is USB-C.
USB-C.
The brand new USB protocol. So it's very kind of like, you know, forward-facing in terms of that. So you need to essentially...
I have seen nothing with USB-C.
Now
this
you have.
This is the very first thing.
Yeah, well, honestly, the first thing I ever plugged in with USB-C was my GoPro.
No kidding.
It has a USB, a normal USB 2.0 or 3.0 end of the end there. But a little adapter you plug into USB-C, and it has an external mic port.
Oh.
So there you go. So these doors are actually a little bit harder to close just because of the rubber gasket. Your battery door on the bottom here is down here. And the batteries come out relatively easy. This is also where your memory card is at the bottom. So I can pull the battery out. Looks very similar to the GoPro Hero 4. Not the same. Slightly higher capacity. And different.
By 1 milliamp hour.
By about 100 milliamp hours. Not a ton. And your SD card goes right next to the battery, right?
It's there, trust me.
It's there.
I can barely see, and I'm sitting next to him, so.
It's right. There you go. Now you got a shot of it. Right down at the bottom there.
Squint hard. See that little thing of color in there? That's the micro.
But the battery's going pretty easy. Door shuts. Takes a little bit, but not too bad. There you go. It also has mics that clear water a little bit better. It's... Overall, say like 8.5 out of 10.
Do we want to know the asking price? Because probably not.
They're $400. Ooh. But that is $100 less than the previous version went for. The previous version went for, of the black, were $500 when they came out. And now the new Hero 5 Black are $399 because they've gotten some stiff competition from Sony. And Garmin Verb.
There are so many action cameras coming out now.
There's a bunch of Chinese competitors coming out now. Overall, I've had a chance to compare a lot of them. This one takes the cake. It does.
What does this have that the others don't?
The image quality is just better. It's just...
But 1080p is 1080p. 4K is 4K.
I know, but a lot of them, they don't have a touchscreen, or they may not have Wi-Fi, or the responsiveness isn't as fast, their battery life may not be as good, it is not waterproof out of the box, requires an external case. This is the easiest to use package out of all of them that I've had a chance to use. I've had a chance to use the new YI, and if you're looking for a bargain action camera, that is well worth your consideration.
Hmm.
It's called YI. They make a 4K action cam, requires an external housing like the old school, like GoPro Hero 4. It's basically $250. So it's not bad, especially at that price point, but if you're looking for like the action camera to get, this is very good. If you're looking for something even smaller, the Hero 5 Session, also really good.
Well, golly.
Yeah.
We should just segment this whole little part off and just do it as a separate review.
Shouldn't we?
Probably not.
Well, I'll tell you what we should,
do. It sounds like work.
Well, before we get to tech news, do you want to do something totally uncharacteristic of us?
Something funny?
Probably.
Cool. I'm down.
It has to do with sports.
Did Doug do his thing?
Doug did a thing. It's a thing. So, all right. We're hoping this will be a reoccurring segment, depending on if Doug runs screaming out of the building and lights it on fire or not.
It better be or else.
Or else.
We're giving you all this exposure to our threes of fans.
Our threes of fans. Doug was kind enough to record us a sports segment with Doug. Like sports scene, or I'll kill you.
What should we call the sports segment?
Watch sports scene, or I'll kill you.
Okay, that's good.
I like that one. I don't know. Probably
Cablevision hasn't used it in like.
He'll probably 10 have years a better so. Name that that's a little less risque. Something along the lines of sports 5 minutes thing.
We'll work on that, but for now
the thing where Doug talks about sports. And now this is funny because I'm talking like I think I'm talking like Doug, and you're getting to see what Doug actually sounds like. After I'm done talking. So, without further ado, here's Doug on sports. Take it away, Doug. Thinking.
Doug's thinking about maybe doing it.
Maybe sports.
Now he's having
maybe
second
not.
Thoughts.
I don't know. Maybe those Blue Jays aren't any good after all.
Those rotten birds.
Sports. I'm not sure why I'm doing this segment. Or Dia. We were just talking about that before this segment started. Remember in my cousin Vinny when she said Dia? Didn't she say Dia instead of Dia?
No clue what you're talking about.
Because we were just talking about deer. The Blue Jays and Rangers brawled back in May of this year, and America didn't want to see any more baseball, but they wanted to see more fighting, so everybody's happy that the Blue Jays and Rangers are playing in the baseball playoffs right now, because Rougned Odor, the Rangers' second baseman, actually punched Joey Bats. That's a great nickname. Or the spray-on beard, as our producer, this segment's producer, Rob, calls him. Joey Bats is an awesome nickname. We're talking about Jose Bautista, the Blue Jays, who was nailed in the face by Rougned Odor. And then, but he got right up to his credit, which nobody credited him with. Anyway, there was a fight. So there was that big fight between the Blue Jays and Rangers. But you flash back to July 2011 when Rougned Odor was in the minor leagues, and he was involved in a similar brawl at second base between Spokane and Vancouver. He played for Spokane. It was a brawl at second base where, again, he took several swings. He didn't connect really on any of them, but he was involved in a brawl back then. Now, on that team, that Vancouver team that he was playing against, was Andy Burns and Aaron Sanchez, who were on that team if only for a short time. They actually didn't play in that game. Now fast forward back, I know this is hard, to May of this year. And when he hit Joey Bats in that game, when Rougned Odor hit him, Aaron Sanchez was actually the starter for the Blue Jays in that game. And Burns, the other guy we mentioned, Andy Burns, was actually on the field during the brawl. If you watch the video, oh wait. If you watch the video, Andy Burns is on the field during the brawl. You can see him. Noah Syndergaard, by the way, who we called Snydergaard for the first 18 years of his career, and wonder why we couldn't find him in a search engine. He was also on that team, although not involved in that game. But the Rangers can't face him because the Mets were eliminated, which brings us to the wild card, which is great. It's awesome because the wild card is only a one-game playoff. Okay, it's one. You don't have to go through a brutal five-game series or a seven-game series. You win one game and you're through, which looks fantastic until you lose. And then it's like 162 games for that. We gave up 9 runs in the first inning, and we were already out of it. It's like, this is going to be a really bad analogy. Tell me if this is a bad analogy. I'm trying. It's like spending $1,000 on a lottery ticket where you have a 50-50 chance of winning $1,000,000. You are 50-50 in, and it's great until you lose, and then you're out $1,000 and $1,000,000. The wild card is fantastic unless you lose, and then you're like, wow, that was like 9 months of baseball we played for that. This week's You Don't Have to Raise Your Hand, Scott award goes to college football because Florida State was still ranked until they lost finally a second game. They were still considered a national championship contender, despite the fact that they lost to Louisville and their very extremely but awesome shiny uniforms. They lost to Louisville 63-20. I apologize, Louisville, if you prefer that. 63-20, and they were still considered a national championship contender. We're still ticked off that in 1983, Miami won the national championship despite losing the very first game 28-3 to a crummy Florida team. Seriously, just count to 63 and tell me how long it takes, and you'll see the game wasn't even as close, by the way, as the 63-20 score would indicate. College football, once again, is awesome. They do this over and over of having teams play head-to-head and then throwing out the results. Why we're doing this feature, I don't know. You could get all this info in half the time on the internet. I'm not sure. NFL, not a lot's happening except guys are running Unicorn 2 Xbox Count Choculas and stuff like that. But Tony Hills was a big deal in college. He was drafted by the Steelers, but the fans consider him a bust. The fans didn't like him. They said he was terrible. I believe he's the only player on the entire Steelers roster to not play in the Super Bowl when the Steelers won the Super Bowl. He's the only guy who didn't play, and after 3 years, he was cut by the Steelers and never heard from again. Until he was, with the Broncos, and then the Colts, and then the Cowboys, who were running Unicorn 2 Xbox Count Choculas against the Packers in the playoffs a few years ago with that catch, it's not a catch, is it a catch, it's not a catch, and Tony Hills shows up. He's in that game, too. He was cut in the preseason, so that was it, but then he was re-signed by the Saints. This is awesome. We're not making fun of him. Average NFL career is 3 years. He has survived 8 years as the most anonymous player in the NFL, and he will remain so because the Saints are off this week. So perhaps this was not the week to do this feature. I'm the last guy who still likes Auto-Tune. I love free pizza. That guy's cool. That's Auto-Tune. Why are we doing this feature?
So, all right, we got Run Down 2 Xbox Count Chocula, man.
That's it. That's what it was.
Yeah? Yeah, man?
Yeah, man.
All right.
So, wait, so Jose Canseco.
So, Jose was Batista, I think.
That's right.
Yep. And he was...
Beat up
He was at third base
right.
in Oklahoma City, and then second base in the library with the librarian while he was beating up the catcher from the same team whose name was Terry.
Wait.
Whose cousin
wait,
he dated in college, but not at St. Mary's. It was at Auburn.
Who's on first?
Sorry, stroking out there. I don't know.
I thought he... No.
What was it? What was it? Xbox 2 or 2 Xbox? What was the first part?
Unicorn 2 Xbox Count Chocula.
All I got, I mean, I got a lot out of that, but what I'm going to remember is Unicorn 2 Xbox Count Chocula, man.
What are you, Canadian now? Eh?
No.
No.
See, he knows. Yeah. He knows. It's not a very good one, but he knows.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. It's good.
I love, man.
What a great emotion.
Sweet
yeah.
emotion.
Unicorn 2 Xbox Count Chocula, man. All right, anyways.
No, but that was a fantastic segment.
That was great. Thank you,
Doug. Thank you very much, Doug. And there better be one next week or else.
Or else. Hey, I hear we have some tech news.
That's a lie.
Eh?
Eh.
Eh.
Yeah, I'll find something.
All right, eh.
Let me put in my secret password, which is Brad's.
Well, you're not ready for tech news?
Well, I didn't unlock the tablet.
Harumph.
But if you ever need to get in, it's your social security number.
So, one?
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
Who knew Brad was the first person ever to have a social security
number?
I'm number one.
There's some sort of formula there. I don't know what it is. Don't really care. But anyways, hey, what's going on?
So here's some short stories. So right now, research...
Man walked off a pier, fell to his death. The end.
The end. That's a very short story.
Here's another short story. Doug did a news story.
That is also a short story.
Yes.
Back to you, Brad.
Thanks. Doug. By the way, how close was I? Is this even close to Doug? I mean, sort of, you know?
It sounds like if Doug and Jay Leno had a baby.
A little bit, you know. Unicorn 2 Xbox Count Chocula, you know? I don't know, man. This is me doing Doug as a different impression, man.
Hey.
Love, man.
Love. Peace and love.
That's really meta, man.
Meta. All right.
Anyways.
I'm trying to... this is going to be our... I'll start one with you.
Are you all right? You okay there?
Nope.
All right.
Okay. So
what's going on, tech news?
Researchers are claiming that humans right now...
Right now?
Based on mortality rates and aging trends, can only live to 115 years old.
Except for the fact that... The oldest person to ever live was 122.
Well, that was then. This is now.
So, but that doesn't make any sense. If people in a time when we didn't have people getting strung along on that arcane healthcare, living to only...
But. What?
But.
In the butt. Now, again, it's worth reiterating.
Uh-huh.
This is a trend-based study. So based on the way trends are going, like...
So you're saying we're eating too much sundaes and ice cream.
Yeah, so if you keep eating all the processed...
Well, that's really the same thing.
That's true. If you keep
Unless someone's eating the calendar, in which case that would definitely decrease the lifespan.
Fiber.
Yeah.
So if you're going to continue to eat all the processed foods, all the frozen bagel bites and all this other shit...
Uh-huh.
You're going to enjoy it now, but not for as long as you would if you just... ate healthier.
You know, I saw a picture of the woman who lived to 122.
Yeah.
I don't want to live to 122 if that's how I'm going to be. Yeah. I mean, it just looked like it was basically the Crypt Keeper with like a bun.
Yeah, but if you think about it.
I am. Really.
No, but think about it. She lived to, and how long ago was that when she passed finally?
End of the 90s.
All right, so 20 years ago.
Yeah, basically.
think about the 90s. Was there, with everything that was happening, was there really much to live for? You're like, oh, it made it this far. It's like, oh, there's
which no, is
one. Look
the
at
more,
the hair. Look at
which
oh.
is all the more astonishing. Why she lived to 122.
Yeah, but look at what we have now to look forward to.
Okay.
We have the Grand Tour coming.
That's true.
Definitely
on
worth
Amazon
living
Prime.
For.
That's worth at least living another.
Absolutely, at least another month or two.
1 month and 11 days.
Yeah. I mean, you got
Final Fantasy. Plus there's one episode every week, so.
Yeah, so at least a while.
A while.
You have Final Fantasy 15 coming out. That's worth living for
is
me.
It,
it is for me. Screw you.
All right.
You have a new, brand new shiny camera.
Yes, I do.
And it's worth living for just to play with that.
And so I can pay off the credit card.
That, well, no, you don't want
to. No, that's right, yeah.
But back
screw
in
screw you, future generations.
Yeah, but back in the night when you're 122 and you're in the 90s, it's just like, yep, this is the end. And
of the world as we know it, and I feel that was a song for my day.
So anyway, back to the actual story. Remember, it's a trend-based study.
You won't get these references in this song because I'm old.
I don't even get half of them. But anyways,
it's trend-based, not a biologically based study, and. You know, that also did not take into account key advances in science and all kinds of other stuff that doctors and stuff can do nowadays.
All right.
So right now,
what they're basically saying is we did the study and it's worthless.
Basically.
All right.
So keep eating that shit and you're going to die at 115 at most.
All right. Well, there you go.
Gears of War is a
franchise. I hear
franchise.
That's a video game.
It is a video game.
The next one's being put out by Microsoft, isn't it?
It is.
Okay,
because you can play it cross-platform on Windows 10 or the Xbox.
That's neat. The only problem I have with Gears of War at this point is the fact that they're all kind of, like, out of order. It's like as if you had made, like, you know, all the Star Wars movies out of order. Anyways.
Yeah.
Ah.
So, actually, Gears of War 4 is coming out this coming Tuesday, actually.
Mm-hmm.
So the brand new iteration is coming.
Neat.
But it is also heading to the silver screen.
Huh?
They are going to make a Gears of War movie.
Why?
Because cash cow.
Oh, right.
They've partnered with Universal.
Why don't they make a Halo movie?
They did.
A good Halo movie. Yeah. In the theater.
So they've teamed up with Universal.
Uh-huh.
And they're going to be bringing all the soldiers and monsters to the big screen. No word on casting, but there is some info.
Vin Diesel.
No. Not for cast. I just said there's no casting word yet.
I'm making a prediction right now that Vin Diesel will be cast as the blonde guy.
No, he should be cast as one of the Flood or whatever.
Whatever
no,
it is. Locust?
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, sorry, I'm all Halo. Mixed up.
I really was.
Play that game more than I do. And
yeah, well, it's been a while. There hasn't been a Gears game in a while. Scott Stuber, and Dylan Clark.
Scott!
Stuber!
Scott Sterling!
Funny thing, I'll tell you after the show. Anyway, and Dylan Clark, which will be known from Ted and the most recent Planet of the Apes movie, will produce, and that's basically all we know.
Okay, so we know who's producing it, we know nothing. Wait, all right, so wait, who's producing it? The guy who did Planet of the Apes and...
Ted.
All right, so... Mediocre.
But if we can actually get a movie out, unlike the Halo one, which is like, we're doing this, we're going to make billions of dollars, and...
I know, but here's the thing. We've been spoiled, and so much as there has been, it is a golden revival of content. And there have been some really great movies and TV shows as of late. So those blatant cash, cash grabs... Like, back in the day when Last Action Hero was number one in the box office after Jurassic Park.
Yeah.
You know? That doesn't fly anymore. It doesn't. It's got to be quality content. So you don't want them to do, like, a one-and-done Gears of War. You want them to make a tremendous Gears of War first movie so that there will be more. And if they do a really crappy job and it pulls in basically what it made after accounting for home video sales, then they're not going to do anymore. And it won't be a great piece of art. So, I'm holding out hope, but not much. So, there you go.
Me either, unfortunately. This is something I'm going to... Ow. Wow, that really hurt. All right, I'm going to try
114.
Some... Yeah. Dick. I'm going to actually try this with you.
No, really, that's... No means no.
That's what you say. So, the story is that...
Should I open up Duo?
No, it's not Duo. Oh, my Lord.
That's your internet porn. You should close the tabs on your browser.
I know. I just can't believe how much is on here.
I believe it.
All right. So hold on. So the story is that Facebook Messenger now has end-to-end encryption.
Okay.
So you can make it fully encrypted from my phone to your phone. Obviously not if you take a screen cap or something like that. And they're saying with the newest update, which is out right meow, there should be a little lock symbol in the upper right corner, or the secret symbol, on the new message screen.
Okay.
I'm not quite seeing that, so I'm just making sure I have the latest and greatest.
I have the latest version.
Do you, though?
I'm sending you a message.
Hey, look at that.
I see no lock.
Yeah, that it says on the new screen, so...
I'm going to delete our conversation. Actually, wait, more. Is there anything I can do? It says more.
All right, hold on.
Block, mark as spam, archive, mark as unread.
Do all the above.
I'm going to delete it.
Yeah. Oh, damn it.
Or I'll archive it. And then I'll go back to your thing and maybe...
So on the new message screen, I have make call or write message.
There's nothing here. So it's a lie! Yeah. It's all a lie!
It says that you can toggle the secret conversation feature on in settings to enable end-to-end encryption, ensuring that nobody can pry. Unfortunately, users have to activate the encryption for every new message. They'll see the option to tap secret in the top right corner.
Oh, I do see secret.
Where?
Up there, when I have your name. Secret. Secret. So I can be...
Wait, what? God damn it.
So as I start typing a name up here, like, or just not even...
No.
On the new message screen. So if I go, like, up here and I go to write a new message, right? And I start typing in your Facebook name.
Right, so there, write message.
Double J37.
Brad.
Secret.
I just have an X.
It says, your messages are already secure, but secret conversations are encrypted from one device to another. You can choose to make these messages disappear, and then you can still report conversations. You can still report conversations even for a short time after the messages have disappeared.
I can request a ride from you. Evidently.
So now I can start a secret conversation with you. I think I've just requested something, didn't I?
I ain't got nothing.
How about now?
Riveting television, isn't it?
It is. Did you get the message?
Did you hear a ding? You did not.
All right. Fine.
No, stupid clipboard, go away.
Well, listen, I can't help it if your phone's a garbage fire.
It's not a garbage fire, it's just lonely.
Works for me.
Yeah, let's go back to this.
This is interesting, too, because I can set like a self-destruct timer on this. It'll be like, boo.
Where you actually have and to I can throw your phone out the window.
I can set it. This will disappear 10 seconds after it's been seen. And I just sent it, and it's got a timer. It's ticking down. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, and there it goes, and it's gone.
Forever.
You didn't get anything?
No.
Can I see your phone?
No.
All right, well, then move on to the next story.
I will. No, I'm angry because I want to do it live to be like, hey, look, it works, and now, well, it works for you. Yes, auto update, that's what I want. What version, well, actually, it's Android versus iPhone, so they're going to be different. God damn it. Well, I have the most updated. Evidently, it went to
well, luckily, this photo will disappear shortly.
Ah.
And it's gone.
And it's
gone. And it blurred out. Look at that. That's kind of neat.
No one will ever see it.
Including you, who I'm trying to message right now.
Screw you, NSA. So, for Apple devices, it's true. For Android devices, for the most part... It is a damn dirty lie. Hey, here's something that should have happened a long time ago. Amazon is now banning reviews posted in exchange for free products. Because when a lot of times when I've gone on to Amazon and looked up products to be like...
But they're the ones sending the product.
Who?
Amazon.
Oh, no. It's like if you go to the Kung Pao company to order your...
All right, let me explain this real quick. Amazon, like, their top reviewers will often get free products.
No, this is the people that are given products in return for a review. Like, we will give this to you as long as you give us an honest review.
How can they tell? Because here's what Amazon does.
Because by Amazon's rule, they had to put in the post, this review was written in exchange for a free product.
Right.
Which I've seen more times than I care
to
count.
Right, but most of the time it comes from Amazon. And you're not required to review it when they send you a free product. Because you're a top reviewer, they expect you to, that you probably will. And if you don't write reviews on it, you'll stop getting free product. But Amazon already does this. Is this from third parties, like sending people product?
It must be, because
it doesn't make any
sense. They're calling it incentivized.
Any sense.
Incentivized reviews. And would you believe that a study showed, which I don't know why they had to do a study for this, that a large number of them were biased.
Oh, the hell you say.
I know. It's weird. Oh, no. So it's now updated its terms of service to ban the practice while making an exception for its own Vine program, which I don't know
what
that
is. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah.
All right. So the Vine program, I don't know what that is.
That's basically, if you're a top reviewer and you review everything under the sun, and they'll go, well, all right, well, here, we're going to send you a product, you know, and we
give us your honest review.
Give us your honest review, yeah.
Which is fine, but I've never even heard of that, and I would have reviewed a lot more if I knew I was going to get free shit. But I digress. So anyway, for non-Vine members, yeah, you're not going to be able to do that anymore, which it's like, yeah, when I look at the ratings and I'm like, oh, I want to get this for my mom. Maybe mm-hmm. she'll like it. It's like, I got this product for, you know, for free based on giving a review of it and blah, blah. I'm like, skip.
Yeah.
Because then you usually get down to where the twos and threes are, and it's like, oh, these are the real people who got it and weren't given a free product. So when I can actually see real people reviewing it along with the other people who are given the free product for it, it's like, oh, so you were paid to do this, in so to speak.
Mm-hmm.
And you were not, and you're all saying the same thing, so I'm okay with this.
Right.
Because when I do product reviews, I'm honest.
But you're usually mad at it.
Well, I'm mad at everything.
That's true. Hmm. All right. Well, that's interesting to know. Good to see Amazon finally cracking down on that, sort of.
And a statistic for you?
Kind of.
Yeah. A statistic for you? Incentivized users are certainly prolific, writing an average of 232 reviews compared to just 31 for regular people.
Wow, that's a lot more.
Yeah, by about a factor of what?
A lot.
Eight, almost?
Yeah. At least seven.
At least seven.
At least.
Yeah. Panasonic.
I've heard of them.
Vaguely. They now have a smart mirror that will find your flaws and then prints makeup to fix them.
Prints?
Yeah. So what is it? It's this mirror, and it has facial recognition and all kinds of stuff. You're getting giggly. I'm not sure why. So it's a makeup applying revolution.
Okay.
Where what happens is that it scans your face. It sees where all of your dark spots, light spots, bad spots are. And it actually has, I don't know if it's like a 3D printer or if it's just like a applicator pad that they just basically apply product to through a machine or whatever. So basically it just plops it out there, puts it out into a little ding, and you go, whoosh. And you go, ding, 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 and it magically makes you better.
What happens when it prints out one of these?
A paper bag?
Yeah.
Yeah, see, if that's the case, then it just thinks you need a lot of that color tone.
Sorry. All I can picture is this, either of us standing in front of that mirror, it's like, crinkle, 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 crinkle.
Well, does that leak? Does it at least put like a smiley face on it or something?
No.
Nothing?
No. Just a plain couple of eye holes.
I hate it when it comes out the eye hole.
Don't we all? Anyways.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Alexa. I'm sure you've heard of her.
Yeah, that is the personal assistant from Amazon. If you have one of the Amazon, we'll call them home hubs, you know, like
home.
That are used to either order stuff or control smart home stuff. You can either say Alexa, which is the keyword. It's kind of like saying Hey Siri for my phone here, or GoPro for my GoPro. You can either call it Amazon, which is stupid, or you can call it Alexa. I'm still waiting for the day you can call it Hello Computer. But no.
Computer.
Oh, mouse, how quaint. Anyways.
Send a message to Commander Riker. I'm going to call you Commander Riker in my phone from now on. Send Great. Commander Riker a message.
tremendous.
It's stupid, but it's funny.
That is funny. I'm okay with that.
But now, Alexa can now lock your BMW and give it directions.
Great, so, I didn't even realize I had one. That's fantastic.
So when you go home
silly
to your...
Silly me, I wasted all this money getting emissions and oil change done on my car today.
So now when you go home to your BMW, and not your just daily driver Honda, it also has Alexa, Apple Watch 2, and Android support.
Oh, well, I still don't have a BMW. This feels unfortunate.
But if you did...
If I did, but I don't.
You could use voice commands with an Echo or Echo Dot to lock your vehicle's doors, load up a scheduled trip, and check the battery and fuel levels.
Neat.
Yeah.
Wow.
All through Alexa. Good old Alexa.
Pretty cool.
She's never let me down
Unfortunately,
yet.
I don't have a smart car, and I can't bring myself to spend obscene amounts of money on a new car. I'm just going to keep this thing limping along for another 400,000 miles.
You would for a Tesla.
I would, but that's a lot of money.
It is a lot of
money.
It's
really a lot of money.
Yeah, it really is.
Yeah. It's like, I don't know, 200 of those things. At least.
Give or take.
Yeah.
Another 200.
Yeah.
Options and all.
Yeah. It's about 400 GoPros.
So, speaking of Panasonic using facial recognition, New York is now going to be using facial recognition and a whole slew of other cool technology items.
Tell us how, Jay.
To catch terrorists.
Wow.
Right.
So you're saying it's Orwellian 1984, where they're just going to monitor everyone through all the street cameras and use computers to determine who's a criminal.
Yeah, exactly.
So instead of using targeted scanning, New York is now using the cameras I said we're only going to use for targeted scanning to scan everything all at once, forever and always.
Yes. No. So, here's what they're going to do. First, they're going to... Now, this is just plan. This is what the plan that Governor Cuomo wants to do. It's not approved, and it's not
Governor
happening
Orwell.
Tomorrow. Yes. So first, what they want to do is they want to give the state's bridges and tunnels a high-tech makeover. They want to do the installation of camera sensors and facial recognition equipment at all crossings, airports, and other strategic locations. So they're going to put all that anti-terrorism stuff in there. But they do have experience with this technology because they actually installed it at the DMV in New York. And to date, since they updated all the stuff in January of this year, they've caught over 100 people that had arrest warrants for various things.
All right, then.
So it's like, you're a bad guy. And then, like, five guys with billy clubs just come out and beat him.
All right.
And they just drag him in a back room and arrest him.
It sounds Orwellian.
Yeah. All right, maybe that's not really what happens, but it really sounds funny in my head.
Sounds really Orwellian.
Yeah, well. Let's see. What else?
Code word for good.
Yep. That's true, too. They also want to incorporate auto-tolling systems.
I believe that's called Easy Pass. Congratulations, done!
No, but if you have an Easy Pass, you just go on your way. If you don't have an Easy Pass, the technology will just take a picture of your license plate, and then they're just going to find out who owns the car, and they're just going to mail you a bill.
They already do that.
Yeah, if you don't pay the toll, you just go blowing through it. But then you get the toll plus, like, a fine, because you blew through the toll.
They already do that. There are several... I passed through several... I have Easy Pass, it doesn't really matter. But I passed through several toll booths that... basically say don't have an Easy Pass because they don't have any non-Easy Pass lanes. Just drive on through. We'll send you the whatever.
I've never seen that. It's always cash attendant.
A lot of places I've been, they have that.
No kidding.
Yeah, like Florida. That's a good example.
Well, that's because Flowrida has their own Easy Pass system. What is it called?
SunPass. Yeah.
So it's like, no, screw you. We're gonna have our own technology and
which is slow as shit, by the way.
Yeah, because when we were down in Florida a few years ago, it was just like.
Well, no, it wasn't even... No, it wasn't that. It was a case of, like, I was down there for a project for work down in the Keys, and I had to drive through, like, 30 SunPass things on the way down to the Keys. Ugh. And, like, the bill didn't come through till like, 4 months later.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, that's not bad. It's like, haha, they didn't get
me. Yeah, but I was kind of like, what's this bill for $13 for?
And $12. And $3.
Yeah.
And $5.
No, it wasn't terrible. It was like... less than $20, I think.
Let's see. They also want to give their bridges a seismic upgrade to make them more resilient and protect them from earthquakes that New York always has.
Well, there is a major fault actually running underneath New York. Like, those disaster movies are kind of startlingly accurate for what might actually happen.
Oh, well. And they also want to cover tunnels and bridges with LEDs that will brighten New York's nights with light shows.
Ooh.
Which I don't... I was like, hey, I'm driving on this
bridge. Oh, God, I'm blind!
I'm driving on this bridge that's over a half a mile in the air, and ooh, pretty lights. I want to stare.
Yeah. Oh, what's going on with the lights?
So I now have a story that I figured would piss you off, so that's why I put it in here.
Okay.
But it has nothing to do with this state, or actually, this is actually just for people who watch us on YouTube.
Then how bad can it be?
Not very, but it's going to piss you off anyhow. Or maybe it's not, I don't know. So Comcast is now... Evil. Comcast is now rolling out...
Chris Hardwick, why did you sell out?
Yeah, well, he has to make money too. 1 terabyte data caps on home internet. And like, they're going the way of Verizon because like... And guess what the argument from Comcast was? Because I gave you a hint.
We're an evil, awful company. You expected this. Come on. End quote. Right?
You're close, but not quite.
Okay.
I gave you a hint as they went the way of Verizon. What was Verizon's huge argument? They said, we're taking unlimited data away, and here's why.
Because we're a huge, evil company, and you should have expected this. So there. But we're still not as bad as AT&T.
Or worthless. Anyway.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, nailed it. Nailed it.
No.
Nailed it.
Because here's their claim. They claim that 99% of customers use less than 1 terabyte of data.
99% of people didn't do anything wrong, which is why we should film everyone and then just make it a Orwellian security state.
So they claim that the median use is just 75 gigabytes per month.
75?
75 gigs. On average. Some a little higher, some a little lower. But now here's the thing. Again, this
seems
is going
high.
Out. This is going out into 18 new markets. None of
Oh, wait. This is home. This isn't wireless.
No, not wireless. Home.
Oh.
I said that. You weren't listening.
F you, Comcast. Real.
I was actually looking through the whole list of states this is coming to. The closest to us is Maine, and I believe... Indiana or Illinois. It's one of those I states to our left.
Still, F you, Comcast.
Right. So, the people who are writing this story said... That's not what they said. They said, here's
funny.
The video. No, that's not right. Here's what they said. Video is becoming a huge thing now. Streaming video is becoming a huge thing now.
It is a huge thing.
Broadcast TV is going to... streaming now, where
yeah.
they have all their own apps that are just stream.
Yep.
Let it be with you, my child.
Yeah, take your content anywhere. That's basically the most broadcasters are going, well, there's this whole internet thing. We should probably put our content there and make money there, too.
Yeah. So not only that, but 4K resolution is starting to become more popular now since
yep.
more people are replacing their older TVs. Video game updates. It's not like 100, 200 megs anymore. I mean, I got video game updates where it's like...
30 gigs.
Yeah, it's like... It's a 7 gig update. I don't think the entire game is 7 gigs. Did they just redo the whole game and just redistribute
it? Pretty much. A lot of times, yes. So anyways, Comcast is an evil company, and you should have expected this.
So
hopefully the FCC steps in and just squashes them.
So what happens if you go over the terabyte a month thing?
They'll charge you a lot of money or slow you down.
Well, no, for the first 2 months, nothing. It's kind of like a grace period. After the third time...
Let's ignore that because they're an evil company.
After the third time...
By the way, did you know Comcast is an evil company? Hey, I'm going to keep saying Comcast is an evil company until it damages their reputation.
Or they just sue you for slander.
I'm going to say it's an evil company. That's my opinion. I'm sticking to it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what they're going to do is that after the third time within a 12-month period of your courtesy 2 months, they're going to whack you $10 for 50 more gigs.
They're an evil company. You should have expected this.
But they're only going to do that to a limit of $200 per month.
Oh, is that all?
But if you think about it, if it's $10 for 50 gigs, $100 would be 500 gigs, and $200 would be another full terabyte.
Yeah.
Do the math. But if you want unlimited data access, you can buy it up front for an additional $50 a month over your current internet bill. Go to that camera.
I think Comcast is an evil company and should be stopped. The end.
Now, here's one thing I'm going to say.
Comcast is an evil company and they should be stopped.
The Not So Late Show, care of Brad. No.
People are going to send me love letters for saying that. Are you kidding me?
Yeah, all the people that are in this area that have Cablevision.
Yeah.
And speaking of, here's the thing about Cablevision / Altice or whatever they're calling themselves today.
Whatever the French company is called now.
Oui. I've never had issue one with Cablevision.
Yep.
I've never had issue one with their service. I have the ultimate 101 data
101. Internet. 101. I don't know why.
And
that, right.
The speeds are always where they say it's going to be.
Right.
There's unlimited. There's no, I've never noticed slowing down.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's great.
Yeah. So Comcast, come back. Go talk to Altice / Cablevision / Time Warner, whatever we're called. What are we called today? Whatever.
Yeah.
Talk to them and get some pointers.
You know what I would
Because they're doing perfectly fine.
You know what would be great is I would love for all those markets that Comcast is in, for those local municipalities to basically revoke their franchise.
I don't know if they can do that, though.
Sure you can.
I'm sure there's got to be language in there that... Says Absolutely. We have the right to change this and that, and you can't do shit about it.
Yeah, yeah, revoke their franchise. Let someone else come in. What else you got?
Well, evidently for iOS, not for me, there is a app called Duolingo. I had never heard of it, but evidently
I've heard of that.
Basically what it is, it's a language learning app. There's others like it. What the hell are they called? Craptastic, Eat, Choke. What the hell is it called?
You all right?
God damn it. I'm trying to find the other...
Duolingo.
Yeah.
I am installing it now.
All right, so basically what Duolingo is, they've just shoved another update out.
Uh-huh.
And you can actually talk to an AI bot in the language that you're learning.
That's pretty cool.
It's kind of cool, and what happens is that it's not like a strict...
What should I learn? Should I learn French?
Yeah, you have three languages right now, French, German, and Spanish.
Okay, I'll work on French.
Because you've already started on French when you went to French. And right now, it's not like a strict of, like you say, ¿cómo estás? And you don't have to say, muy bien. Mm-hmm. There's actually like different things you can say, so it has a loose learning.
Right.
And, So it's kind of cool that you can actually talk and it'll talk back to you while you're learning your language.
Well, I'm not talking to it yet, but all right.
So if you're talking to it and you can't think of what to say back to it, it actually has a button called Help My Reply.
Uh-huh.
And it'll actually come up with some things to...
Okay.
Of ways you can respond back to it to help your learning. So I thought that was really cool.
Oh, damn. All right. I got it wrong.
Oh. Let me correct myself real quick. I read ahead and skipped one little important sentence. Right now, you can only interact with the chat box via text, but in future updates, Aww. They will have spoken versions as well. And hold on. I just have to return a text real quick.
All right, well, there you go. That's neat. Cool app.
Bear with me a second.
You all right? You okay? Everything going to be all right?
Nah.
All right. Nah, all right, it'll be fine. Doug, how you doing in there?
So far, so good.
So far, so good. Not on fire? Fantastic. Apparently, Jay is on fire. Maybe. Maybe not.
I might be a little.
Hey, don't forget to visit our YouTube page, youtube.com/NSLSTV. We also have our Facebook page, facebook.com/NSLSTV. Facebook.com/NSLSTV. Twitter.com/NSLSTV. You can email us complaints, compliments, suggestions, anything you want to see us deep fry. Deep Fried Friday coming up in a little over a month. to nslstv@gmail.com. And you can also watch our midnight replay if you missed any part of the show. It's at midnight tonight. So an hour and a half after the show ends, you can watch it all over again. It's not midnight. Well, it is midnight Saturday, but it's not midnight going into Sunday. It's midnight Friday into Saturday. An hour and a half after this ends, it's there again. But you can watch us anytime on youtube.com/nslstv. Jay, what do you got?
Or Monday when I finally upload it to YouTube.
That too.
Okay. This is actually something I was quite perky about. Amazon's latest Prime perk is now free books and magazines. Now, it's not an extensive library. Like, here's our entire Amazon library.
Is there a particular app for that? Like, or is it just your Prime app?
It's called Prime Reading. So if you want to look that up to see if it's a separate thing or if it's just part of... excuse me, please. So basically what they're saying is that, oh, you have videos, you have shipping, you have this, you have
that.
Well,
I mean, they have Kindle, right?
Right, but I don't know if it might be part of Kindle inside of it when you sign in. It's like, oh, you have access to this shit. All
right.
So basically they're saying, well, the bookworms, quote unquote, didn't get a lot of special treatment.
Okay.
You know, you got like one free book a month out of the Kindle library.
Sure.
But if you're a bookworm and you like love to read, I just don't know how to read. So
says the guy who just read a book.
It took me like 5 months.
Details.
You know how long it took me to sound those words out?
Maybe.
Harry? Took me forever to figure out how to pronounce it right.
Ha.
Ha. Harry.
Hey. Her.
So the Kindle Unlimited service was a separate $10 a month subscription.
Uh-huh.
Introducing
Prime Reading. I'm reading this from their app right now.
Hey, cool. What does the app say itself?
Read as much as you want from over 1,000 books, magazines, and more, all included with your Prime membership. Just look for the Prime logo on eligible titles.
So it's like Amazon Prime Video, where it's like, here's our entire library. Can rent this for this price, but if you see the Prime logo, you can just read it for free.
Let's see, what do we got? Do they have, like, I'm looking for, like, popular science or something like that. Oh, magazines.
Yes, they do have...
So here's what we got. We have National Geographic. That's cool. I like that. Bon Appetit. People. Oui. Sports Illustrated. HGTV. Popular Mechanics. Now we're talking.
Perked up a little.
Entertainment. The Good Life. Cosmopolitan. Shape. Bloomberg Business Week, Outdoor Life, Vogue, GQ, Sound and Vision, Condé Nast.
These are all Prime?
These are all Prime.
Really?
Transworld, Snowboarding, Shutterbug, Baseball America, Town and Country, Esquire, Four Wheeler, Transworld Skateboarding, Snowboarder, Stereofire, Martha Stewart Living, Baggers, which it looks to be motorcycle, Men's Health.
Like, is that for like supermarket employees?
Coastal Living Magazine, Harper's Bazaar, Sunset Magazine. I'm almost through here. Rachel Ray Every Day, Motorcyclist, W Magazine, Consumer Reports, Automobile, Motor Trend, Powder, Surfing, and Working Mother. So I see a couple out of there, Popular Mechanics and National Geographic, which I am going to, and there's a couple more. I can do like Sound and Vision and stuff too. And but
that's a Sound Vision you have there.
Popular Mechanics, yep. I'll read for free on that one right now.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
See, my tech news is worth something every now and again. So as Brad
just looks
went
like
through,
you can, it looks like you can only read the current one on the shelf.
But
it's downloading now.
That.
I'm not going to waste our screw it. I'll waste our day.
Glad you. What are you on mine?
No.
No.
Doesn't really matter. Same thing.
I was going to say. So they're saying that this has a carousel of content. So basically, all that stuff is going to refresh.
Right, so at the
so
end of our, so November slow. It'll be a new issue,
yeah, exactly.
December new issue, yeah. So right now I'm pulling.
But
up.
That's also for the books, the magazines, and
yep,
whatever the hell else they said they were giving us. Magazines, comics, and short works along with books.
I wonder if they'll. I don't think any audiobooks are included in those, are there? Because that would be interesting.
It was a dark and stormy night.
Ooh, I'm reading Popular Mechanics.
Read by B. Arthur.
See? Popular Mechanics, I'm reading. Probably isn't the time to do it.
Ooh.
It's popular.
In the future. We don't know what's happening. All right, moving on because we're running shorter on time.
Yep.
So last week we did the whole big reveal of the iPhone 7 and 7 Plus
yes.
SQ limited edition, whatever.
Uh-huh, you were saying.
So now Google had their big reveal of the Pixel and the Pixel XL.
Of course, it got spoiled a little bit by a couple of phone companies revealing early, but yeah. Hey.
So here are the highlight points of the new Pixel and Pixel XL.
Okay.
This is basically going to be the high-end phone, so it's basically a direct competitor with Samsung's Galaxy line with iPhones.
Well, it's
iPhone
about time
lines.
They came out with their own. You know, they have an OS that is super fragmented, so it's about time they came out with something that was like stock. Here's what we envision the phone should be.
Yeah.
And their camera is rated very highly.
Very highly.
It's the highest-rated sensor that DxOMark Mobile has ever measured, and they're kind of like the adjudicator of like how good a quality sensor.
The sensor and the speed of it.
Uh-huh.
The speed of the processor that's shoving it through is actually very impressive, they said, to the point where it, like, HDR is automatically on.
Right.
And it takes so many photos and puts it together and shows it to you, like, within a fraction of a second.
Uh-huh.
It's not even funny.
Oh, it's funny. Ha-ha-ha. It's funny awesome.
So the standard Pixel, which is a 5-inch screen, has a 1080p AMOLED display. The XL has a 5.5-inch AMOLED, but has a quad HD screen.
So, which is 2560 by 1440, in case you were wondering.
Both have the quad-core Snapdragon 821 chipset with 4GB O-RAM. The smaller Pixel has the 2770 milliamp hour. And the Pixel XL has the 3450 milliamp hour.
Decent battery.
Yeah, I mean, I think this one has something very close to that with the
3400. I'm sure, yeah.
12.3 megapixel cameras and HDR plus mode. Let's see. The cool part is the new handsets, the Pixels, will come with unlimited cloud storage for full res pictures and 4K video.
That's cool.
So dump everything into your Google Photos and it's not going to touch the data that they give you.
I love it. If it's one thing Google has a lot of, it's storage space.
Yeah, I don't even know how they do it. So that is the new Pixel. I don't know when you can pre-order now.
But here's the thing. You can pre-order on their site or through Verizon.
Verizon, because they're the exclusive dealer. And
yeah, which is interesting.
We have Verizon. Yay us.
I don't care. I got my iPhone 7 Plus and I'm happy.
For now.
For now.
Okay.
For now.
Chevy is...
To the levee and the levee was dry.
True. They're bringing hydrogen fuel cells to the military.
I saw they built like kind of like a special forces truck.
It's a Colorado.
Yep.
Which is the new
not
style.
The Wyoming.
No, not the Wyoming. It's the Colorado ZH2.
Uh-huh.
I bet you the H stands for
hydrogen.
Oh yeah, that too. That makes sense.
Uh-huh.
Oh. Yeah.
Get a H2 cool. Hydrogen. Yeah. Nailed it.
So it's designed to test the feasibility of fuel cells in the military.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the hydrogen, the power plant is much quieter and cooler running than the conventional gas motor. So when you're doing certain types of operations in enemy territory, you don't want
lower
the
lower heat signature and a much lower
diesel
heat signature.
Yeah, much lower.
But it can generate a lot of power, Jay.
Oh yeah.
You know how much power?
25 kilowatts.
And 50 kilowatt peak.
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 But if you just have it sitting there idling, 25 continuous.
That's a lot of power.
I think I could power my house off of that.
You could, actually, yes.
That's phenomenal.
You could power a couple houses off of that pretty easily.
I will run an extension cord to your house.
Unless you're like several people are running hair dryers all at the same time.
And a toaster.
And
the
yeah.
microwave.
And the oven.
And put the hair dryer in the toaster and put that in the microwave.
That feels like a Top Gear challenge. Like, they have the truck, like, this produces 25 kilowatts of power, and you just have like 30 people with hair dryers. Truck's on fire.
This does have some inherent performance advantages.
Such
high
as?
High torque.
Yeah, you know, because it's electronic or electric motor,
all electric motor, so you're going to high torque, high fuel efficiency.
Right.
And you can even reuse the cell's water output.
Right, because it's potable water.
Hydrogen has a byproduct of water.
Mm-hmm.
So you can actually just use that too.
Yep.
And having exportable power can make it easy to fix vehicles where you can actually swap out fuel cells right in the field.
Which is really cool.
Click, click, click.
Sure, it was very expensive to build, but, you know.
But that's a problem for our tax dollars.
Details.
They're planning to test the ZH2 in extreme field conditions next
year. Extreme!
Extreme! It is not very expensive, but it's expensive to produce hydrogen, and it's not as readily available as fossil fuels.
Not yet.
So they're going to see how that does, and they're going to go from there.
All right.
Whatever keeps our guys and gals safe over there, that's what I say.
Hoorah.
Hoorah. And finally, our final story as we're coming nearer to a close. Facebook has a new app.
Is it the Messenger thing we just went over?
It's called Facebook Messenger. It's brand new.
We just went over this.
We did?
We just went over it.
All right. So then we got another story that Facebook has come out with yet another, just this second.
Great.
A new app called Facebook Events.
All right. Well, that feels like something I don't care about.
Exactly. So that's why I'm going to bore you with it.
All right. Go on.
So what it does, it helps you find stuff to do.
Oh, there was a 3.2 earthquake in
New York. Damn it.
Honoka.
Uka Buga?
It's near Waipio Valley.
Ah. So, evidently, there's a lot of event-finding apps out there, which I've never heard of one of these, called Yplan, Eventbrite.
Yplan.
Exactly. And Songkick. Because when I think of, I want to plan my day, Songkick is the first thing that comes to my mind.
Yeah, really?
No. And so, evidently, Facebook wants you to make them their go-to event planner. And evidently, they've been trying this for a while. So now it's taking a huge stab at their competitors by making their own app as a standalone. So it's available on iOS first.
Okay.
So you actually get an I don't.
What's it called again?
Facebook Events.
I'm already disinterested.
Well, I know you are. So basically what it does is that if you're looking for something to do, it'll give you a filtered feed with all of your friends' activities. So if it's like, oh, I went to the Goshen Fair, or Brad's at the Simsbury Flying and Car Show, and
I don't even see it yet.
Pat was run over by a go-kart and killed horribly.
Oh, events from Facebook.
Maybe that's what they call it.
It's called events. So if you're looking for it, it's called events from Facebook.
Not Facebook events.
Because
like,
I like the first result is like $4.99. It's like, oh, damn it.
Okay, so evidently it's called events for Facebook because
from Facebook.
God damn it. It's called events. Look it up. If it's made by Facebook, you got it.
I guess.
So, and I actually have not been on Facebook in over a month, and I really don't miss it.
No.
But, so basically, before I went off Facebook, there's a lot of people that's like, oh, Brad's interested in this event, which you've never done, but you're an example because you're sitting here.
Sure.
So it's like, Brad's interested in this event, or Doug is interested in this event because he just blew the dust off his Facebook account. And so then, if you're looking, it's like, I'm bored, I'd like something to do, you go to events from Facebook, or for Facebook, or fuck Facebook, I don't care anymore.
Either way.
Yeah. You can go like, oh, let's see what everyone else is doing. It's like, oh, Brad's at the Simsbury Flying Car Show, that could be cool.
Neat.
Doug is interested in an event of waxing cars in the parking lot of Walmart or something, I don't know. So now you don't have to go through your news feed to see like what everyone's doing. It's like, I wonder where everyone is. I have no friends. Somebody please be my friend. There's also a search tab if you want to search for specific events, and it'll let you filter events by time or location. So it's like, what's going on round two? Nothing. God damn it. There's also a heavy image-heavy carousel that sits further down with suggestions, which they're presuming comes from things you like, your history, and where the hell you are in the world.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. There's also a calendar tab accessible at the bottom that will give you an overview of everything you've signed up for. So evidently you can sign up for things in this app, too. It's not a full calendar app, but they're trying to make you go to them for all of their
I guess if you
needs.
Have a social life, that's probably good. But for us effers who don't have social lives, well, there you go.
What's a social life?
I don't know. Oh. All right.
Now I feel lonely.
Me too.
Did you know there's a hurricane?
There is.
So I'm coming here. Evidently, it's a little ADD, and it's just like, no, I'm going to go over here.
Remember, it's important to give blood, because right now, all those blood donation events all along the eastern coast have been canceled.
And hurricanes fear blood.
So if you have a chance to see a blood drive near you, head on out to your local Red Cross blood drive and give the gift that gives life.
And Brad's actually giving 12 pints tomorrow, and I applaud you for that. Not after the 12 pints, but
yeah,
they say the body only has 8 pints, but the brain hides a lot up there too.
Yeah. I'm fat. I probably have extra.
Hooray. Bonus blood.
Bonus blood. That needs to be like a thing in Halo where you like, you know, if you get like 13 grunts in a row, it's like bonus blood.
Oh, that'd be fantastic.
Kill-tacular.
Yeah.
Bonus blood.
Yeah.
I like it. Or oh, you know what it should be? We're talking about this video game stuff here. If you know you get like a kill-tacular or something like that, or like one of those.
Kill-trust.
And you kill something in the middle of while he's saying that, it's like bonus blood. That would be great.
That would be fantastic.
That would be funny.
Actually,
that would be funny things to say in a video game, but not in real life.
Right to 343. Suggest it. Right.
Yes,
now.
343. Do it. Who produces Halo video games? All right. Well, we want to cut this a little bit short, so
because Doug wants to go home before midnight tonight.
Yeah, details.
Because all right.
So, do we want to get to what we learned today?
Okay.
All right. Oh, well, first let's do, while you're thinking of that, let's do all the plugs. YouTube.com/NSLSTV. That's YouTube.com/NSLSTV.
What did your watch tell you?
Told me to stand.
You're dying, Brad. Stand up.
No, it's an exercise thingy. Ah. Facebook.com/NSLSTV. Twitter.com/NSLSTV.
Never updated.
Email me complaining about how much you love Comcast at NSLSTV@gmail.com. That's NSLSTV@gmail.com. And if you missed any part of the show, watch our midnight replay at, wait for it, midnight, which will be in about an hour and 40 minutes from now.
Give or take.
Thereabouts.
Seven.
After Meet the Leaders and Neighborhood News, you can sleep through that, set your alarm for midnight, start it all over again.
Wake back up. Or, because it's Friday night and you're just getting home from partying, stay up another hour and a half.
Yeah, why
you're,
the hell
you're
not?
Still wired.
Yeah,
from
you're watching. Who cares?
You just did a walk of shame. Who cares?
So, Jay.
What?
Wait.
What?
Wait, learn me up. How is this positive? Two hurricanes separated by 9 yards in the same sea. I didn't know this could happen. That's
called the perfect storm.
It is. The hurricanes rotate around each other, actually.
Yeah, so they're like dating. Seriously, they could work off of each other. Well, though she's, what, a tropical storm or a tropical disturbance at this point? Something
this
like
feels like a crappy love movie.
Is that Nicole?
Yes.
Ah.
They're in the same area code. How is this possible, even though oceans don't have area code?
Because there's a party down there in Miami Beach.
Yep.
Hey.
All
right, well, that explains it.
Hey, yeah. Doug.
Yes.
What'd you learn today?
Yeah, what did you learn today, Dick?
I tried to learn a little something about hurricanes, but it didn't work.
Well, goddammit, you tried anyhow.
You tried, and learning...
Nobody's talking about Nicole.
No. That's because Matthew's destroying the joint. Because
Nicole's going to fizzle out. She never... Nicole will never amount to anything!
What about all the sailfish that she disturbed a little?
Think of it this way. If you went to a party and you had Nicole, who was just kind of very
wallflower.
Pretty, very, yeah, just a wallflower, just kind of sitting there minding her business, or then you had... Matthew, who was just wrecking the joint and smashing shit and
fire.
Lighting the curtains on fire and smashing out the windows of the
blowing
car
up
outside.
The Transformers.
Yeah. Which one are you going to talk about afterwards? The wallflower or?
I mean, Hurricane Matthew is blowing up more Transformers than Michael Bay.
Damn. That's a lot of explosions.
Boom!
Literally.
Obviously, Nicole, because she would blow dry her hair and look incredible, even though she looked... You know, like a wallflower.
Did she
but
walk?
But then
walk down the stairs.
Yeah, but then the ZH2 would run out of power.
That's true.
Yeah.
But did she walk into the party in slow motion?
No, and she walks down
toss
the stairs
her hair
in
back
slow
like.
But I thought like any. Didn't you watch not a, a. No, scary movie.
Then toss her hair back in slow motion. None of us know what that feels like. Anyways.
I just learned I have a lot of preconceived notions about parties, and I've never been to any, so I don't care.
So sad.
Mm. What'd you learn?
I learned that these orange dry things from Polar really make me have to pee a lot.
So that's why you really want to cut the show short.
A little bit.
By a few minutes.
A little bit.
We're going to draw this out to the last second.
I also learned that I learned so much from Doug, and...
Dig.
Frankly, if I learned nothing else, it's that... Unicorn, you know, Unicorn
Xbox.
2 Xbox, Count Dracula, Count Chocula, I don't even know, just hit the damn football. Man, love.
Laces out, Dan.
And that, my Doug is alright. I mean, it's not great, but this is kind of Doug. It's not...
And Jay Leno.
Sort of. This is Jay Leno.
It's Doug Leno.
It's Doug Leno. That's alright. All right. Anyways, hey, thanks for watching.
Let's just sit here and stare awkwardly at the camera until Doug goes to black.
Or I can slowly inch towards the bathroom.
I think you should do it slow motion like you just walked into a party. With the hair.
It's not going to be slow motion in a second.
How many of those did you drink?
Before or after the show?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, here he goes. He's given up all hope. Oh, wait. No, he is going in slow motion.
Slow motion. Way to the bathroom's the other way in slow motion. I really gotta pee.
It's been a couple minutes and I'm still sitting here. I'm lonely. Somebody come keep me company. They don't let me go home.